the next room? We got here, some kind of like warp core or something. Hmm.
You look but see nothing of note. You look but see nothing of note. Small containers of oddly colored liquids. This seems to be the main monitoring station for the beds. Above it is some sort of dispensary.
For these beds. Okay, so you go on them, and it dispenses this... Is this medicine or something?
You look but see nothing of note. You look but see nothing... This seems to be the main... Small containers of oddly colored liquids. You look but see nothing of... Dr. McCoy, who isn't arguing as much with Spock as usual. James Kirk, the paragon of a Starfleet captain, feels nothing like a paragon right now. Mr. Spock, your loyal science officer.
Your friendly neighborhood science officer.
Lieutenant Bukert, his is not to reason why, his is to obey orders and stay alert.
His is to ask how high.
Sometimes I wish I'd become an archaeology professor instead of a Starfleet captain.
Are you religious, Jim? Is Harry Mudd a divine punishment for anything we did wrong?
I can't think of anything we did that was that bad.
You look troubled, Captain.
Sorry if I was bothering you. I was just silently cursing the day I met Harry Mudd.
Okay, we get it. He's horrible.
Captain, count your blessings. We haven't met any salt vampires, deranged computers, blood-draining clouds, cell-imploding sirens, Greek gods, or any of the other things that people keep telling me about in security.
There's not much I wouldn't do to not have to deal with Mudd.
You think the salt vampires was the first ever episode? What about this part?
You look but see nothing of no-
Analyze, Mr. Spock?
Nothing to report, Captain. Nothing to report, Captain.
Nothing? This is very, very interesting.
This room closely resembles the Enterprise sickbay. The beds are powered, as is the central post console.
We won't be able to operate any of this equipment unless we can learn more about the aliens, Jim.
There is nothing at the moment for me to do there.
Red shirt. Go lay there.
He looks at you with a puzzled expression.
Alright. Is this where he came through?
You look but see nothing of no-
Yeah, we came through there. Oh no! We did not. What's all this?
You see a plain gray screen.
I was looking at this.
You see a plain gray...
That's this.
You look but see nothing. A control console from which operators run the ship.
Hmm.
A control console. You look but see nothing of note. You look but see nothing of note.
All this stuff?
You look but see nothing of...
Nothing of note?
You look but see nothing... You look but see nothing of note.
Yes.
You look but see nothing...
But it's all so interesting. How is it not of note?
You look but see nothing of...
What about this?
You look but see nothing of note.
Oh, brother.
James T. Kirk. Mr. Spock, Vulcan. Dr. McCoy is still frowning. Lieutenant Bukert looks intensely at these controls and suppresses a childlike impulse to touch them.
Spock?
Evidently the aliens bridge their centralized control. A closer look may provide more information.
Indeed.
Mr. Spock, come take a look at this. This is evidently the main bridge. What do you make of it?
This is clearly the control center for the ship, Captain. I cannot deduce much information, but I do observe two things.
Oh.
Go on, Mr. Spock.
This station definitely is configured differently from the one beside me.
This shouldn't be surprising. After all, there are two stations.
That may be, Doctor. But if you'll recall, all the Enterprise's different stations link into the same computer network bank, and...
What else can you determine at this stage, Mr. Spock?
These people have a fixation for the number six, and even divisors and multiplicands thereof. Threes and twelves in particular. I believe this may be the necessary first clue to understanding the aliens.
Threes and twelves.
Mr. Spock, come take a look at this.
This station
Mr. Spock, come take a look at this. This is evidently the main...
This station definitely is configured different...
Mr. Spock, come take a look at this.
This station...
Okay, so...
You fail to obtain anything.
Can I actually manipulate any of these things?
Mr. Spock, come take a look at this.
This station definitely... We've done quite well so far, Captain.
In spite of Harry Mudd.
Speak of the devil. Where is that little angel?
Hopefully back where he left him.
I'm speechless, Mr. Spock. Words cannot adequately describe this place.
Boldly go where no man has gone before. We are here, Jim.
This may have been their bridge, but this sure doesn't look like the Enterprise.
Why should it? What's this thing?
You look but see nothing.
Can't go off. Okay. Oh, wait. Oh, oh my. What the hell? I've got viewports and this. I know all of these big spheres. And this one broke. What the hell is all this, man?
The sphere in the middle of this console appears to be some sort of control mechanism. You look but see nothing of note. You look but see nothing of note.
It's broken.
You look but see nothing. You look but see nothing of note. You look but see nothing of...
These are all of note. The hell?
The data view screen is operational. The information selectors are controlled from the console platform.
Lieutenant Buchard seems to have limitless energy. It makes you feel old just watching him. McCoy is his usual crusty old self.
He makes us feel younger looking at him.
Sometimes you wonder if Spock will ever show emotion.
Don't hold your breath waiting for it.
Kirk is silently worried about what is happening back on the Enterprise.
This technology is unbelievable, Mr. Spock. I've never seen anything like it.
It is indeed impressive, Captain. If I were capable of emotion, I would be in awe of this place.
If you're incapable of emotion, how do you know what awe is, Spock?
True. You can know the definition of it, but if he's never felt it...
This is a major archaeological find, Captain. I believe the galaxy may actually have cause to thank Harry Mudd.
You can't be serious, Spock.
Don't ever say that.
It would be nice to think that after all the stunts that Harry has pulled, that he would do something right for a change.
Oh, God. Listen to Bones.
This equipment's way out of my league, Jim.
Captain, does this mean that I'm a part of a major archaeological discovery?
You better believe it, Lieutenant.
I don't see why you're complaining about this Mudd guy. Who knows what advances we could get from all this knowledge?
Well, is he even going to let us mess with this stuff or take any of this stuff? This is like his bona fide discovery or something. Let's analyze stuff.
This platform contains the control console for the ship's computer library. Data may be accessed by using this console.
And then he walks over.
Nothing to report, Captain. Nothing to report. Apparently an information data screen. Something like the display readers on the Enterprise. Nothing to report. Nothing to report.
Okay, can I actually interact with this thing?
There is nothing at the moment for me to do there. There is nothing at the moment for... There is nothing at the moment for me to...
Now this is a view screen. How do I do anything with anything? What if I take this thing and use it to interact with this thing?
You can't seem to make this work.
Damn it.
Nothing happens. Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
I wanted to give it to him. Alright, where do we come from? Here? Or there? Oh, okay, we went around there. I didn't even see that there. Okay.
Nothing happens. Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
Well, we can clean stuff with, this.
Dust and grease lifts off the surface, leaving this item clean as new. Dust and grease lifts off... Dust and grease lifts...
Oh, this is gonna say that for anything. It even said that when we used it on Harry Mudd. Hey! Is that you, Mud? What you got?
Why, Captain!
I saw you.
Jim, that doesn't look good at all. Harry, let me take a look at you and check whether that had some deleterious effect.
Hey, he's freaking out.
You're all space aliens. You're little gray men from inside the hollow earth.
Oh my.
You want to experiment on my body parts? Stay away from me!
Dementia.
Deleterious effects. I guess I don't even need my tricorder to know that.
You'll mind control me, kidnap my children, dissect my dog.
If we can get him on one of the beds and get it active, I think he can be cured. Otherwise, he's likely to become increasingly violent.
Stay away from me!
Huh.
There's nothing there requiring a ship's doctor.
Well, you have to analyze him. He's sticky poos.
Arcord Fenton Mudd, three of the most prominent psychologists in the galaxy, became famous by publishing case studies in sociopathy about him.
Yeah, and now he's not only a sociopath, but he's going to become a psychopath as well. Can we coax him into...
No, you're going to sell me to space aliens! Use my brain as a weapon to destroy the human race! Then here I am, willing to help out in a good cause.
I think I liked him better when he was less delirious.
All right.
No, you're going to sell me to...
I think...
How do we get him into one of the beds? Can we just clean the stuff off him?
Dust and grease lifts... Dust and grease lifts off the surface.
You look troubled, Captain.
Sorry if I was bothering you. I was just silently cursing the day I met Harry Mudd.
How do we get him into one of these...
Captain, count your blessings.
There's not much.
You look but see nothing of note.
How do we get him into one of the beds?
Nothing happens. Nothing happens. Small containers of oddly colored liquids. You look but see nothing of note.
He broke it.
Arcord Fenton Mudd.
Well, I don't know how to get him into one of the... I mean, unless we take him.
You fail to obtain anything.
Okay, you can put him into the bed. Ooh!
He's unnaturally strong, Captain. I can't take him down.
Alright, phaser's on stun then. Kinda sad we can't put it to kill, actually.
I don't think the phaser will have the usual effect, Captain. We'll have to think of something else.
Yaha! I feel faster, smarter, strong enough to take you all on!
Oh
you're
my.
The lizard men wearing human masks. His is coming off! I know you for what you really are. I'll tell the whole world, and then where will you be?
Right here, apparently.
I don't think the phaser will have-
Yaha! I know you-
I'm not fast enough to get him with a tranquilizer hypo, Jim.
Well, I guess we'll have to come back.
There's nothing there requiring...
Nothing requiring a ship's doctor.
Nothing to report, Captain. Nothing to report. This room closely resembles the...
Okay. Let's... look around some more. Well, he's back over here.
Kirk, my friend! When have I ever given you the slightest bit of trouble?
There was the time that
perhaps there have...
Don't push your luck, Harry.
Kirk, my friend!
Wait.
There was...
Perhaps there have been a few...
Don't push your luck, Harry.
So he's okay again? I mean, what the hell?
Harcourt Fenton Mudd.
Now that's a problem with the game. There's only one of him, right? Alright, so either there's legit two of him, somehow, and we don't even know it, or there's a problem with the game. He can't be here and insane, and super powered, and back in the other room and being completely fine. Oh, another room. Hopefully something in here.
Tall, transparent cones run through the ceiling. Energy crackles in between the dodecahedrons inside them.
Right.
A save-a-ship emergency life support generator generally used for temporary life support during evacuation of small damaged ships.
Evidently, Mr. Mudd was unwilling to pay the price for a reliable salvage model.
Tall, transparent cones run through... You look but see nothing of note. You look but see nothing of note.
Another claw.
A large claw-like device hangs from the ceiling. A salvage lock hatch, a common type used to link a derelict to the ship doing the salvaging.
It appears that Harry Mudd managed to emplace this access hatch without significantly damaging the alien ship.
Will wonders never cease?
Well, yeah, looks like the whole friggin' thing was melted.
You look but see nothing of note. You look but see nothing of note. You look but see nothing of note. You look but see nothing of... You look but see nothing of...
Mm-hmm.
You look but see nothing of
okay,
note.
Enough.
James T. Kirk, exploring the unknown is one of the few pleasures that the burden of command allows him.
Poor Kirk.
Spock continues to examine the equipment with a scientist's eye. McCoy glances back and forth looking for a sign of Harry Mudd.
There's two of them. Watch out.
Lieutenant Bukert watches and says nothing. He's the strong, silent type.
When we get back to the Enterprise, you're gonna have to tell me everything you know about this Mudd guy. Sir.
You know, Lieutenant, they say if you can't say anything good about a person, you shouldn't say anything at all. In that case, I've got a lot I shouldn't say about Harry Mudd. Well, Jim, as long as we don't strangle Harry Mudd, I can't see very much for me to do on this mission.
Let's hope there isn't too much for you to do back at the Enterprise. Just think of it, Spock. An advanced civilization with powerful technology and nearly unlimited knowledge, and yet all of that didn't save them.
It is a sobering thought, Captain. Unlike humans, I do not decrease my efficiency with meaningless dialogue.
Spock, meaningless conversation is one of life's great pleasures.
Is it now?
This save-a-ship life support generator has seen a great deal of use. It was never a reliable model, being prone to break down without warning. It is, however, properly connected, with warning alarms for temperature, atmosphere, and radiation. An unusual matter-antimatter engine, reminiscent of the designs created by the Hupuan of Seganus IV.
The Hupuan?
This room appears to have been the alien ship's engine pod, a ship-to-ship access hatch, and a temporary life support generator are evidently recent additions. As one would expect, Mr. Mudd has sealed the hatch with his personal code. We cannot enter his ship, Captain.
I suspect that's a blessing in disguise, Mr. Spock.
There seems to be a crane of some sort, Captain. Currently, no power is running to it. This room appears to have been...
Oh, I don't know if there's anything we can do with anything.
Nothing happens.
This life support generator is an unreliable model at the best of times. Tinkering with it is a gamble with your life.
Nothing happens.
Why can't I press the buttons? Maybe Spock needs to press the buttons.
I fail to see the logic in that action, Captain.
Huh. To see what happens. Yeah, come over here, press it. Oh, cool. Oh, I thought it was gonna grab Spock.
The device has finished loading, Captain.
Cool. Now what? Tell us what the hell we're doing.
A most interesting technology, Captain.
If the Alassi gets hold of this, they'll...
Okay.
An elaborate piece of alien-looking machinery. An elaborate piece of...
A weapons delivery system. It appears to be an accessory tied directly to the alien equivalent of our ship's... A weapons delivery system.
Okay, so now what? Can you press more buttons, Spock?
I believe, Captain, that this weapon must be hooked up through the main weapons battery. However, I've already examined the weapons console. And the main weapons battery on this ship was completely destroyed in the action, which made her a derelict. Mr. Scott would have to go over this thoroughly, but I would recommend we try to take this weapon with us to the Enterprise.
I don't think we should tinker with technology we don't understand, Spock, and I'm surprised you'd suggest such a thing.
That's no good. I don't like that choice.
I agree that we should take it aboard the Enterprise. I'll try to raise the ship. Kirk to Enterprise. Kirk to Enterprise.
Yeah, let's do this. Choice 3. That didn't do much now, did it?
I believe, Captain, that this weapon... However, I've already... Mr. Scott would have to go...
I don't think we should tinker... I agree that we should take it aboard the Enterprise.
Do this one.
I'll try to raise the ship. Kirk to Enterprise.
Same.
Kirk to Enterprise.
Hope she's not talking about the neutral zone. What about the yellow buttons? I'll take it back out.
The device has been unloaded, Captain.
I can see that.
The device has finished loading, Captain.
Okay, so the blue loads, the yellow unloads, and this just... We need power for it.
I fail to see... Unique, Captain. I believe these are self...
Power boosters! Oh, I've...
Evidently...
The technical...
The machinery to deliver... A weapons delivery system. It appears...
Well, that's certainly interesting.
This seems to activate the ship's computer bank control node. Given the alien's predilection for multiples of three, it may be possible to use our tricorders to decipher the information carried in these data banks.
That would be quite a find, Jim. This is an alien race unknown to us, and they are certain to have knowledge new to us.
Yeah.
Were the universal translator available, this would be simple.
With the Enterprise out of range, that's not an option, Mr. Spock. What else can you do?
I believe if Dr. McCoy and I conjoin our two tricorders, we may be able to process enough sample data to get a basic understanding of the alien's computer system. This will completely tie up both our tricorders for an extended amount of time, however.
Yeah, why the hell not? How do we tie them together? Here we go.
Both our tricorders are now working on basic processing of the alien's computer data system. The tricorders are not the equal of the universal translator, but we should be able to retrieve basic information and get an insight into their culture and life systems. I don't believe we could have gotten even this far had we not deduced their fixation on base six mathematics and aesthetics.
True.
The tricorders are again available for general use. The alien ship's computer data is now accessible from the ship's library. I believe I have downloaded enough information to our tricorders to enable operation of most of the ship's controls, Captain.
Yay! Now, is this the library, or is that other room the library?
Not all topics will necessarily be available, Captain. Nor do I believe we can get full details on all data. The tricorders could only do so much processing. It would be worth our effort to locate the central data banks for delivery to the Corniforos Life Sciences University, I believe.
To say nothing of fulfilling our mandate to seek out new life and new civilizations.
I'm receiving data now, Captain. Most internal and external functions are controlled from the bridge. These include engineering, navigation, communications, and sensors. Weapons functions are controlled from the weapons room. I have found an entry on an experimental long-range weapon booster recently installed, named the Wyos weapon. It does not alter the power of the primary weapon systems, but it does increase the range at which those weapons are effective. I believe I can produce a picture of a member of their race, Captain.
Ooh. By all means, Spock.
Cool.
Look at their physiology.
Six
Jim.
Eyes.
I think this explains the Lachaeans' fascination with threes and sixes.
What's her name?
It should be no surprise that physiology affects mind and behavior. I would say a six-fingered, six-eyed people would naturally develop their sciences and arts around base six numerical systems, just as I observed on the bridge.
Indeed.
Medical knowledge is comprehensive and lifespan is extended considerably over archaic expectations, with maintenance of quality of life. Interesting data here about the six-eyed vision processing in the brain. Their eyesight must have been excellent, and almost 300 degrees around.
Hmm.
You look but see nothing of note.
You've got to be kidding me.